So now we are going to extend our discussion in terms of different scenarios of import and exports. We could have different scenarios. For example, you are a company who manufacture goods in UAE and sell them in KSA, Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. Your supplier manufactures things in France and he sends goods to you. You receive it on the port and you re-export it to South Africa. So this could be a different scenario. You have taken an office in free zone on a port like Jebel Ali. You bring goods from America, you store them in a warehouse, and when you get an order from Africa or from other countries, you are going to invoice them. So actually good does not came in UAE. So these could be certain scenarios where just goods are received in UAE and they are re-exported. Then the other scenario is goods has been arrived on the port, you have shipped them into warehouse, then from warehouse you will enter inside the UAE. So what could be the possible VAT consequences? This is what I am going to explain in this discussion. First of all, the basic knowledge should always be in your mind that there is something called zero rated and there is something called exempted. If you are exempted, if your item belongs to exempted category, of course then there is no VAT and there is no need for applying any rate on it. But if it is a zero rated, so of course the process, VAT invoice, everything will be the same, just you have to apply a rate of 0%. So what we need to know is that how, when we are going to export to within the GCC. Now GCC is the Gulf Economic Council. How it works is the same pattern as United Kingdom and European Union works. So if you want to understand the model between UAE and the rest of Gulf Economic Councils, like countries like Saudi Arabia, so how you need to understand is the same conceptualization you can do, that when a person, a company based in UK is going to sell goods in France, so how they are handling the VAT transactions. This is what will be in the base and it will help us in all kind of VAT planning, and you can see a business impact analysis using these basic concepts. So if you're a company who is based in UAE and you export to GCC is outside, this is for sure, if you met some criterions, this will be considered as zero rated. So what are those criterions? It can have two scenarios. One is either it's a direct export, or one is it is an indirect export. Indirect export, if you have an evidence that you have exported the goods actually physically, or either it remain in any place by custom authority for 3 months from the date of supply. Indirect export will be this way, that the goods will arrive in UAE and an agent is going to export them. So we have to see that the goods are physically exported or they are kept in area by customs authority for 3 months from the date of supply. There is no alteration in the shape of goods, so there is no conversion cost applied on it. So these are two main conditions. If you met these, then of course the export outside the GCC export will be zero rated in this case. If you move your items internationally, so there could be some other rules that you have to understand. Your goods are in UAE and you are exporting to some other country, and it can be a different opposite scenario, that the goods are coming from outside country to UAE itself. This is irrespective of destination of the transportation. It may be a scenario that these services are supplied during the delivery of the goods, so you are just a handler in between. You are just arranging the insurance, or you are just arranging the goods. So in that scenarios, of course, there is no VAT liability on your shoulder and it will be zero rated. Let's see, if you supply the goods to the GCC's country, so what could be the possible scenarios? Of course, as a general rule, any export to GCC country is not subject to VAT. As we know as of today that there is a VAT system now in UAE and there is a VAT system in Saudi Arabia as well. So we have to see that how these two countries are going to handle their individual transactions. Suppose you have a company in UAE and you have a sister company in Saudi Arabia. This is very clear that if you are four or five companies, so you will register yourself as a group. So you will, within the group transactions, will not be subject to VAT. But once it goes to from UAE to Saudi Arabia, then you have to see it another way. You can claim for your VAT that you have paid for the production. That will be a recoverable cost for you. Any kind of scenario built this way, that you are a exporter in UAE, you buy things from UK and the goods arrive to you and you sell them in South Africa, for example. So in that case, there is no tax VAT liability over your shoulders. If you want to claim your import recovery, you want, there are certain conditions that you have to meet. The first condition, that is, you should be registered, you should have a VAT number, you are a taxable person. VAT on purchases is correctly charged, calculation, there is no calculation error, and you have a proper invoice showing all the necessary details. Good and services acquired for a purpose, and this is a permissible purpose. Amount of VAT is either paid or intended to be paid in near future. As an exporter, any point of time when your purchase tax, the VAT you paid on purchases, if it exceed the VAT that you receive on sales, then the difference is going to be your recoverable. So how we are suggesting to our small, medium clients, what they should do is they should create four folders at least. One is for purchase invoice, one is for purchase return during the quarter, and then they should have a sale invoice and then sale return, means credit note and debit notes, these in accounting term. So then you have to maintain this, all the details which will at the end will tell you that you have a recoverable amount from federal tax authority or you have to pay further amount. We could face a very likely scenario which is quite prevalent in UAE is consignment stock. What is a consignment stock? How it works is, for example, like you are Jumbo Electronics and I am Sony manufacturer. So as a part of deal, I display my stock on your showroom. Customer comes, they like, when they buy, then you invoice. Before that, it's just a movement from my warehouse to your showroom. So all accounting good size softwares like Oracle, SAP, they handle the stock movements properly. If you are using other softwares which are good in handling the stock movement from one warehouse to another warehouse, this is very important for you to do, because it's all these all transactions are related to VAT. So once they will sell your stock, it will become an invoice and it will be your sale. But before that, any unsold stock which is just moved on the base of consignment on sale basis, this is not going to be considered as eligible for the VAT calculations. Now we can see a scenario that we are going to create call of stock. How it works, You have supply of the stock is on 1st March 2018, for example, and then time of supply is TV taken from the stock 1st of April 2018, invoice issued 1st May, and if you see the remaining stock has been at the recipient premises for 12 months, so this is 1st March 2019. So what would be the scenario in this case? VAT is due at the time when it is the goods will come in your possession. If the stock has not been approved and accepted by the recipient, then for this 12 months period, you have to see that what would be the accounting and liability that you can create for that. In order to understand the GCC movement, what you need to do is, if you're a company based in UAE and you're a company based in Saudi Arabia, so first of all, you have to register with Saudi Arabia and then in Saudi Arabia as that entity. And here UAE is going to, your company is going to register with FTA. So both you will have a VAT registered status in both the countries. And depending on their inter-GCC requirements, then we will advise how to handle. It is zero rated, exempted based on the sector. We can decide how we can establish the VAT liability in general.